start my talk, which was scheduled, I wanted to speak two things. Actually, one was related to, of course, World Heart Day. So we have public wants to know the prevention, but we have been talking all through this. So let me talk a little about TAVI, which has been my favorite subject, because the reason being that I've been working with Dr. Alan Krivier. So let me just slide share this. And so it will be, this is my favorite topic. I have been talking about this TAVI since 2002, I would say, ever since the first valve was. Can you see the slides now?
Yeah, we can see.
Okay.
We can see. Yeah.
I have been talking because the first TAVI was done in 2002. And I have been working with Professor Ella Kibir 1996, 97, 98. So when the thought was process was going on, then animal experimentation was going on. So I was in Rua with him. And I used to travel to Paris sometime to do some those animal experimentation. So in the beginning, let me share one experience of myself. In the beginning, I was traveling in his car. He was driving. That was early, late 1996. He said, he has a project in mind. Two projects. The first project, he said, was a non-surgical aortic valve, and second, he said, non-surgical bypass, which he could not do. Maybe he will do a little later. So this was something which was going beyond my mind at that time. Then how will you do it? He said, he will do it, then tell us later. So now everybody knows TAVI, and so the plan of presentation will be the scope of problem of degenerative aortic stenosis, balloon aortic valvoplasty. I would like not to show the case report and development of this. So the aortic valve stenosis, 26% of the population of the age of 65 years has mild, moderate, or severe disease. 2% are symptomatic and should require treatment. It is estimated that within 15 years, the number of aortic stenosis patients will nearly double. Surgical valve replacement is a treatment of choice. As of 2 years back, I will take the final slide will tell everything. Overall, in standard risk patient, mortality after aortic valve replacement is about 2% to 5%, depending upon the comorbidity factors. And after successful valve replacement, the patient lifespan returns to normal. This is very important. So that is what. So the first step in Rua, 1985, the first balloon aortic valvoplasty was performed. In the 1980s, age per se was a contraindication to AVR. In general, 95% of AVR patients were less than 75%. This was a highly symptomatic patient, and it was actually a heroic effort to do balloon aortic valvoplasty done by Professor Alan Krivier. Highly symptomatic, several syncope attacks, and of course it was a memorable reaction to the medical community. It was published in Lancet in January 11, 1996. The patient 2 years after symptom returned to the normal life. So basically a Krivier Latak balloon. What is Latak? Latak is a professor and head of cardiology when I was there, and Krivier was number two. Later on he became the chief of cardiology and Latak retired. So the name of the balloon was actually Krivier Latak. This was the balloon which they were using at that time. So following that, many times, thousands of patients were done with the balloon aortic valvoplasty. But of course, the problem was, early limitation was re-stenosis. Valvular re-stenosis was a big problem. And solving this issue became a personal obsession for Dr. Krivier. And he thought that let us do something bigger than this. So if you see 1985 to 2002, there was a huge time gap when Dr. Alan Krivier discovered this. And in between, he did. So what he was thinking is, don't undertake a project unless it is manifestly important and nearly impossible. This was actually a nearly impossible project which he took. And this was Edwin Land who said this, and he further on. Why this was highly challenging? Developing a TAVI was an unrealistic project. Why? The purpose was implanting a valve process.
No, I don't play the EB project.
To unmute somebody, I'm the host also. Let me see who is speaking. I don't know. Okay. So why this was important, this difficult? It's a highly challenging because valvular calcification surrounding structures, coronary arteries, mitral valve. Major clinical issue was coronary occlusion, mitral valve injury, permanent atrial blocks, stroke, aortic regurgitation, prosthesis migration and non-lasting results. This was a challenge. The user observation during BAV, any calcified valve can be circularly opened by high pressure balloon, and a balloon expandable stent with a high radial force might keep the valve open. This was actually observation. A valvular structure would have to be attached within the stent. And this is a challenging combination of balloon expandable frame and valve structure. A challenging combination of a balloon expandable frame and valve structure The opinion of experts, everybody said at that time, I want to tell you that Medtronic and Edwards, Edwards and Medtronic both are the maximum seller of this valve today at 2020. The project was submitted to all biomedical companies, including Medtronic and Edwards, opinion expert. And what were the opinion of experts? Technically impossible, clinically dangerous, irrelevant, the most crazy project ever submitted. Because whenever you are doing something new, you need a sponsoring company. So finally, they what with Martin Leon, the percutaneous valve technologies was done. That's for the new company. It's going to 10 minutes. I will speak and within 10 minutes. Oh, sorry. Okay. Okay, how to go back? Sorry. Are you seeing the slides now? Still? Are you seeing the slides?
No, no. No. No.
We can't see your slides.
Okay, just a minute, just a minute. Actually, I have to, the last time it was upgraded, it is not upgraded one, so it keeps coming. Okay. How to go back? If you allow me, I can stop share and start the screen share again. Can you see the slides again?
Yes, sir. Yes, yes, it is visible.
Okay, so yes, valve technology was the company which was started by them. And at that time, the following 3 years, April 16, 2002, with Rouen, France, first in man implantation was done. And this was 57-year-old man, cardiac shock, multiple comorbidities. Transseptal approach was used at that time. It was transseptal femoral vein going into the through the vein, right atrium, right ventricle, right atrium, left atrium, left ventricle, and then implanting the valve. Retrograde approach, transseptal. A lesson from this: the feasibility of TAVI was established. There was no THV embolization, no coronary occlusion, no MR, no AV heart block, no mild AR, and therefore it was established. It was a bomb effect, as he told Dr. Kribas tells. And it was cited in 3,700 articles, published in Circulation 2002, percutaneous transcatheter aortic wall implantation done in calcific here. First human case, Alan Kribel, Alan Elshanov, number two, and then other people in the lab. So this was the birth of this, April 16, I told you. What is... So challenge was to demonstrating the potential benefit of a disruptive technology on a subset of critically ill patients with life-threatening combustion. So from 2002 to 2005, there were 40 patients iRevive and recast trial. It was again published in JACC, General American College of Cardiology, in 2004 and 2006. Out of this, the things were transcatheter valve crimping device, Nimet balloon, 24 sheath, French sheath in femoral vein. This was a 24 French sheath in femoral vein. It was a Quine pericardium, single size, with no, four patients survived more than 5 years, one patient survived more than 6.5 years. This was the compassionate patients. So this was 33-year-old lady, day two, and this was day 15, and she lived 6 months post-TAVR, and 1 year post-TAVR, it was with lot of people there, and this was actually 83 or 2 years post-THV, 83-year-old, and 6.5 years post-TAVR. This is a very important patient. That is why Dr. Kribel always tell. Coming on to the TAVI, spectacular worldwide expansion happened. Expected growth of more than 40% a year. 2019, 1,44,000 patients have been done. 2020 till today is 163. So it is expected to grow potentially. And by 2025, this is going to be about touching 3 lakhs. The France alone is doing 15,000, 65,000 being US. So where are we today? TAVI is a breakthrough technology with an incredible expansion worldwide. This was a balloon expandable Edward valve. And then, of course, Medtronic Evolute R is a self-expanding valve. Till now, in 65 countries, total, as of now, more than 660,000 procedures have been done. And coming onto the steadily looking into this, I was just telling you, I will skip a few slides because of the time. I have to speak another 5 minutes, and then we have to reconnect. So this was what I'll tell you, compassionate patient, revived trial. And this was a patient day one, and then 6.5 years, I already told this thing. first ever planned retrograde Tavi. Okay, coming on to this, at this stage, the reason of success was improved technology and skill, better patient screening, image technology, echo and CT, better experience, improved devices, procedural data, a large body of scientific evidences, Tavi registries, evidence-based trial, high risk, intermediate risk, and I will just go on to the partner trial. So after the Edwards took over in 2004, Edwards acquired PVT, the same company which had discredited and they never wanted to come with Dr. Cribier. They acquired PVT. And now Cribier Edwards valve is now changed to as Edwards Sapien valve. So this is what happened. At the same time, transfemoral technique was being developed and retrograde technique by John Webb from Canada and transapical from Lisbon, Germany. There were three technologies coming up. So if you see the advancement from 2005 to 2009, Sapien XT and 2012, Sapien 3, the sheath size from 24 French to 18 French to 14 French. And of course, at the same time, the core valve, which is now Medtronic Evolute valve, from 2006, they wanted to develop a self-expanding valve, while Edward and what Dr. Cribier has developed is a balloon expandable valve technology. So coming, I'm skipping a few slides again in the interest of time. 92% of all TAVI cases in Rua are done by minimalist approach. What is minimalist approach? When you are doing a local anesthesia, a mild sedation and no general anesthesia. While in America, still, most of the centers are doing general anesthesia and they have a surgeon on standby. The local anesthesia, sedation on demand and no transesophageal echocardiography and of course, closure devices being done. Coming on to the registries and the trials, I'll just go on to the trials, which is partner one, partner two, and partner three trial. I'm skipping a few slides, time is less. So this was the partner 1B trial, which showed the TAVI is superior to the medical treatment in inoperable patients, published in New England Journal of Medicine, and that was 2011. And then TAVI versus surgery, partner 1A trial, TAVI is equal or superior to surgery in high-risk patients. And after this, it became the FDA approved it. Then partner 1A, TAVI surgery at 5 years, no alarm on durability. This was again 5 years data. And the core valve I'm skipping. So TAVI is the future, might coming on to the no alarm. I have to skip a few slides because this is a comprehensive lecture. I have only 2 minutes left to finish off. I would like to tell you, I have skipped the partner 3 trial. Actually, partner 3 trial is an important trial which has shown the importance of this in the low-risk patient. That means even in the low-risk patient, TAVI can be done. Where is the partner 3 trial? I think it's skipped out. So, okay, doesn't matter. The partner 3 trial results are also available, and that has shown that even the low-risk patients, a TAVI can be performed with as comparable to surgical aortic valve replacement. So age is the key. In the younger low-risk patients, less than 70, in the absence of anatomical contraindication to TAVI, a well-informed patient, whatever his age, refusing surgery might have been the next future, the deliberate choice of undergoing transfemoral TAVI. Keeping in mind that SVAR remains an option, emergency, urgent or planned in case of unsatisfactory acute result of valve failure on follow-up. TAVI in younger age, similar results. The expanding TAVI, other clinical indications, bioprosthetic heart failure, bicuspid valve, severe asymptomatic AS, it is also new technology. Moderate aortic stenosis with heart failure may be an indication for TAVI. High-risk aortic regurgitation can become, and there are few studies going on, aortic stenosis with concomitant disease like CAD and low flow and low gradient. So the last slide would be expansion and future of TAVI, a new paradigm. TAVI is conceived in 2002 for patients who are not optimal candidates for SAVR. Now, surgical aortic valve replacement is indicated in patients who are not optimal candidates for TAVI. So this is what is the future from 18 years down the line when the first TAVI was performed. More than 6 lakhs patients have been done worldwide, and this is what is going on. So I finished my talk here. So let me stop sharing the slide. And we have to have now, it is 1 minute left. So if you allow Mukesh and other people, then rather than having a hard stop, let me close this and we can restart again because a 40-minute session, which is being extended. And I welcome my friend Satinder Singh, who has joined there. So he will be speaking a little because although he's an orthopedic surgeon, it's a cardiology webinar, but he will speak a little about it in the later part. So if Dr. Rakesh Gupta is there, Dr. Mukesh Goyal, Yashpal, do you think that I should stop it here because it will stop automatically otherwise? I will close this meeting and I will request everybody to join immediately after I close it. So that we'll have another 40-minute session. And Mr. Athavale has joined, actually, and Honorable Minister has joined. So, but I will stop the meeting now and I'll request everybody to rejoin.